Greetings, minions. I should have cleared my throat before I started doing the introduction. Oh, fuck, mate. Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker. And I'm just here with some more Let's Play an Indeterminate Amount of Sunless Sea. The series whose name is a complete and total fucking lie, because the number of episodes is predetermined. Right, so, got a couple of things we need to do before we can head out to the sea. First of all, we need to sort out our boat and our supplies, because we are lacking both in food and in hull. Our hull has suffered. Our hull has suffered. No, our hull has suffered. So let's visit the Admiralty Yards and get that fixed up. Lovely. All sorted out. And let us go to the shops and sell some shit. I'm keeping hold of the Scintillac. I also really want to keep hold of the Stygian Ivory, because that might be useful. Casket of Sapphire. Because I kind of want to keep all of this shit. I'll sell the sapphires, because I know that that's valuable. Because I feel like the firkin of prisoner's honey is definitely going to come up. I can't think of when Stygian Ivory will come up. You know what? I'll sell two of the bits of Stygian Ivory and I'll keep the rest. Let's also actually sell some fuel. How much hold space do we have? 35. It's going up to 18. Actually, no, knock that down to 15. Knock that up to 18 for the simple reason that fuel runs out a fuck ton faster than supplies. And now we could head out! If it wasn't for the fact that we've got a visit from Mr. Sachs, who is the Santa Claus of Sunless Sea. Midnight. A presence dominates your lodgings. Its fur-trimmed robe is the red of blood on snow. Over your chair hangs a familiar brown sack, bulging with offerings. Londoners give generously to the crimson beast of winter. Anything to be rid of it. The figure stares into the fireplace, smelling of soft musk and harsh ammonia. I require a sturdy vessel and a captain. Yours comes recommended. You will suffice. Yep. Yeah. Oh, we're not being forced into it. Okay. Okay, Mr. Sachs is a rather worrying figure who essentially demands things from you. I believe he appears in the Christmas events in Fallen London. He's a rather grim and grisly beast, and like everything else of any power in the Fallen London setting, he's a creature whose motivations we don't fully understand, and quite frankly, I'm glad we don't fully understand. Now, we could ignore him. You know, we could put him off. There's no penalty for this. You'll be able to accept this contract at a later time of your choosing. We could put that off. But number one, that feels weird, telling Mr. Sachs to fuck off. And also, what else do we have to do? Like, I don't actually know where we're picking that up. Collecting cargo for the Cheery Man. We need to go to Khan's Heart. And find Scintillac. Like, that's all we have. We don't really need to go anywhere else. So, we might as well take Mr. Sachs on board, if only because he's quite interesting. I generally tended to not, for some reason, I hadn't quite gone into my head the importance of getting involved in the storylines in this game at the time, like a while ago. And then they introduced Mr. Sachs, and I did his storyline, and that's what got me really properly invested in how he's supposed to play this game. So, you know what? We're going to take Mr. Sachs. Mr. Sachs, take my service. An ancient contract. Words not to be spoken lightly. A deal is struck. The beast withdraws its hand from the fireplace, examining it. Packed. Lacra? Lacquer? Lacra? Lacquer? Dunno. Neath snow. It disappears back into the... Incarnadine robe. Three deliveries by your release. Do not tarry. You have much to lose. And we are now in the service of Mr. Sachs. The Crimson Beast of Winter lurks in your hold. Take too much time and he may take you. Yep, this is fun. Read the morning papers. Okay, we got some more supplies. Cool. Okay. Oh, if we have a secret, we can actually tell Mr. Sachs to fuck off. The Crimson Beast of Winter lurks in your hold. This is not a healthy situation for you, your ship, or your crew. The first delivery. The creature calls for you. It is time to begin. A hunger that can never be sated. Mr. Sachs is waiting, clutching what looks like a leg of a lamb. The meat is rotten. The bone is well chewed. A fool sought a name that devours. It devoured him. A lifetime's wealth wasted on cravings that can never be satisfied. When all was eaten, he stripped the meat from his fingers in search of solace. Still, the hunger gnawed and screamed in his belly. He thought this pitiful offering of poison might free him. Debts are not so easily paid. Okay, so we have to deliver rotting meat to either Khan's heart or to... My God, this is running like ass. We either need to deliver that to Khan's heart or to Pigmoat Island. Now, do we actually know where Khan's heart is? I believe that Khan's heart... I think it said it's... I think it should be somewhere around here. But at the same time, we could just go to Pigmoat Island to drop it off. The thing is, we need to go to Khan's heart anyway. Do you know what I mean? So, quite frankly, if I have done this storyline before, so I recall that the deliveries you make for Mr. Sachs do not end well for the people you make the deliveries to. Do you know what I mean? Hello. Oh yes, I forgot. We can actually, when you find these light ships, you can actually, you can do stuff on them. We can purchase fuel, or we can give them news of home. In the bleaching glare of the lens, among the smells of oil and metal, you sip tea and chat. The Z's terror recedes. So now we have another Z story, and our terror has gone down a fair bit. But I'm it's gone down a bit, not a fair bit. Although I'm imagining that our crew is probably a bit unhappy with the fact that we've got essentially a fucking boogeyman equivalent hanging out on the ship. Like, that's probably a bit of a fucking problem for them, you know what I mean? Hey, Captain, why have we got Krampus? You know Krampus from the movie Krampus? Why have we got Krampus from the movie Krampus on our film? On our boat? I don't actually know which came first, Mr. Sachs, or the design of Mr. Sachs, or Krampus, but the kind of creepy, vaguely monstrous, but clearly somewhat intelligent beast. You know, it makes sense. Also, I genuinely have no idea why the game is running quite this badly. I also don't know if this is actually going to show up on the recording, because sometimes frame rate issues don't show up on the recording for some reason. But yeah, this is pretty oddly bad running, because this game tends to run fine, because you know it's entirely two dimensional. Whoopsie daisy, don't go into the maelstrom. I don't know what happens if we go into that, but whatever it is, it can't be a good thing, so let's try to steer away from it. Well, that bound shark just starts getting sucked towards it. That's good. Could you stop being interested in me, please, bound shark? I've got no interest in fighting you. And again, really weird, creepy, atmospheric music. It's a deeply worrying kind of audio soundscape this game presents, it must be said. And again, there's my favourite message, Saint Erasmus dancing. There's a certain point in this game when you realise there's really not much to say. Which again is the reason why I'll never do a full playthrough of this. Because, you know, you can... It's very easy, and indeed the game kind of wants you to lose yourself in the atmosphere of the slow trek across the Z. Just hit full power and turn the glim lamp off. That should do it. I mean, yeah, no, that isn't particularly a threat. Oop, station 3. We don't have much we can do there right now, but it's good to have that on the map. Try to ignore the giant really fucking deeply creepy... Oh, you prick. Try and ignore the giant deeply creepy face down there. What the fuck is that? Unfinished pirates. Okay, that's worrying in and of itself. Yes, station 3 here. Station 3 was an area that filled me with a strange amount of dread for a long time. In this game, it must be said. Like, it was genuinely threatening until you actually... And then you actually start doing the plot line for it. You'll see why it's worrying once we dock. We may infer that it may infer a Station 1 and a Station 2. We may conjecture a Station 4. Machinery hums behind high steel walls. Up the hill, there are visible outlines of warehouses and a building with a spire. But the lamps are low where they burn at all. And your ship, the only one in the harbour. Try a telescope on the shore. Church? Something else. You stand on the high point of your ship and look to shore. There is a steepled building on the horizon, by far the largest thing in sight. No cross marks the top of it, nor any other symbol you recognize. We could try the gate, but you need a soothing Cooper long box, which I guess is a coffin. You need to deliver a coffin to get in. Could search for signs of other visitors. We're not liable to succeed, but we'll give it a go. No evidence. You walk the quays, or keys, I'm still not sure, looking for any little sign that might show what sort of ships dock here and what they deliver, but you find nothing conclusive, not even so much as a smear of pitch or a damp footprint. If any ship but yours has been tied up here in recent days, it has left no evidence. Okay. Yeah, the fact that the only way to get in there is to deliver the coffins, which I could never find. I had to actually Google a way to, like, where you can get hold of these coffins. I can't remember how I got hold of one. But, it's a really distinctly disconcerting place. We hear those voices that will not be drowned. This is the Sea of Voices. We are close to Polythreme. Where nothing is truly dead. You know, there's an awful lot of things out here on the Z that, I just seem to have trouble dying, man. God, these faces are weird. They're not a threat, as far as I recall. But they are... They are something, just something really fucking creepy. And because we ran across unfinished pirates, I knew we'd get here soon. Another relatively important port. Polythreme. Or however you pronounce that. I'm gonna say it's Polythreme. Ooh, the crawling stars. The lookout shouts. Far above, the false stars on the cavern roof are now shifting. A rare and ominous event. What now? I can have the eyes on deck. I can record the change and assign a name, which is a 50-50. Ah, cool. One Zayla claims it resembled the sun. Another, a Hindu mandala cross. A third suggests the rose window of Chartres or Chartres Cathedral. This excites mockery. Nevertheless, the reaction is positive. Good. Good. So we got. So our terror went down. It's always a good thing when your terror goes down. And here, we're going to meet the clay man. Polythreme. Here is screaming. Taciturn clay men, evasive clothes colonies, walking like humans. Cobbles that groan underfoot on the hills above a palace villa of marble, but even that writhes like buried bones in an earthquake. Sir, gather intelligence. The king with 100 hearts rules from his palace above the city. He is never seen. He makes no treaties with other lands. But there's unrest in the air. The clay men you speak to are obedient and humble, but they speak nervously of those who are not. The maimed, the rebellious, the unfinished. Sadly, we don't have a watchful Kyuri, otherwise we could actually go and talk to the rather disturbingly named king with 100 hearts. Carry clay men to London. Do we have 6 units of cargo space? We do have 6 units of cargo space. Are they passengers or cargo? They're certainly the easiest passengers imaginable, unless, one of them turns out to be an unfinished man. They troop aboard. Each one lies down in its appointed position next to the other, nested snugly, head by foot. We are for London, one explains to you. It's just a good way to make money, that, well. Oh, you can also buy them. You can buy what the We Are Clay thing, which adds your engine power, which is actually a fairly good thing, honestly. Let's just sell them Stygian Ivory, which actually sells for slightly more here. I almost want to buy the clay, man. A tree of clay stokers will reduce the crew requirements, but also crew capacity, and will slightly increase engine power. They're fitted to an auxiliary slot. When they're not in use, they will stand patiently, hands by their sides, flat grey eyes, unreadable. One will say, sometimes, I like it when it's quiet. I don't know, I'm not sure we can actually afford that. Yeah, let's leave it. Okay, back out to sea. I'm hoping we can find Khan's heart. Because if we find any indication of the Khanate, then we should. Because there's a few ports that are all very close to each other. Try to ignore the giant frog. I always do. But there's a few ports that are right next to each other that are all related to the Khanate. And so if I can find one of them, that means I'm very close to the other. Sea of Lilies is to the east. Particularly tormented bound shark. I mean, that makes sense. Ow! This is why I don't like bound sharks. Because they do an awful lot of damage and... Okay, I'm sorry. How were we hit? We were hit like 4 times when we were miles away from the, shark, though. Dark wisdom. Fuck me. Nupidmidit, whatever, built this place as a prison for the Khanate. No, it answers only to its governor, and its governor answers to no one. Let's compile a port report. Ships from the Khanate are most common, but you see Chelonite vessels, Polythrium Tremes, or Triams, or whatever, with chained and sulky unfinished men, corsairs disposing of their miscreants, even one furtive Remy skiff. The wardens pay them well for their prisoners. Oh, we can buy supplies. That's good. Because we're running a bit low on fuel. Shame we can't get a repair, though, from that fucking shark. Right, let's keep going. I want to find Khan's heart before we end the video. Yes, there's something underwater to the northeast, I know, but we don't have a submarine, so stop telling me. But if that's there, that we shouldn't be too far from the Khanate. Ooh. Khan's shadow. We are very close to the Khanate. Khan's shadow is kind of an open port. Like, kind of an open, kind of black market port. It's kind of like Guider's Morn, but for the Khanate rather than London. Which means that the place we intend to go, Khan's Heart, is just a little bit to the east. Or the west, I don't know. I can never get there. It can't tell me east or west. There, it's up there somewhere. Khan's Shadow. Mark on my chart, thank you. Long ago, the Khanate turned its back on its warrior traditions. It has no place for pirates and would-be nomads. So here, in the shadow, the exiles make their home amid 100 wrecked, grounded, decommissioned ships. Follow port report. Oh, we can buy stuff. Oh, and buy fuel. Can we afford a Miracat box? Yes, I think we can. Yes, I bought 2 Miracat boxes. The reason will become clear later. Okay, off we go. Mirror catch boxes are incredibly useful. Like, incredibly useful. They can catch and hold sunlight. And to the right people, well, sunlight's an illegal product, but to the right people, sunlight is a very valuable product. If you can find the right buyer. You know what I mean? Okay, he's yes, here we are. I don't know if this is the right part of Khan's Heart, because I believe there are 2. But let's pull in here and see if we can't get what we're after. Khan's Heart, London's rival. An oasis of light in the salt-black wastes. Canals thread the painted city. Street lamps glow and water taxis putter. Let's get the Chewman's cargo. You meet a blue priest in a tiny noodle shop by the Moon Canal. Fizzing electric light shows the weary lines in his face. You have my money? He asks. Indeed we do. Oh, your stupid imperial coins. No, give it here. It'll do. It's what was agreed. Take this. Go. You never saw me. Stamped crate of brilliant souls. Yes. That's going to be a problem, I imagine. But we can also deliver the thing for Mr. Sex. A hunger that can never be satiated, rather. The copper quarter pulses as the feast... Drowning pulls? Its people gorge themselves too quickly to taste the food on their lips. Their cheeks bulge and their stomachs swell. But still they eat. The white and golds wade in to silence the growing mob before it can escalate further or set its sights on the royal food stores. Yeah, and now the Khanate is a bit skittish about us. No, there's no shops available for us. Actually, let's check a commercial license. The car... Fuck knows. Dislike merchants, and they dislike foreigners. Foreign merchants induce paroxysms of antipathy. Perhaps sufficient bribes will buy your way into the Neferite Quarter. Not here, Surfacer. Surfacer? These guys have been generations underground. And to them, all Londoners are surfacers. It seems you'll need to go to Khan's Glory, the nearby places of nobility, to seek a license. Which is the other port. You know what? I don't even know why I'm considering checking, because I know we can't get a license right now. Oh, hello. Flee the nightmare. Well, we have a 100% chance of success, so... The sea churns in your wake. You pull away from the eye into the shallow waters of waking, but a terror clings. Lost our menaces, we lost a restful night's sleep. We succeeded. Nightmare's end. Your dreams have passed. That's good. Isn't it? Oh, so we actually lost the terror. So we gained a terror from having the nightmare and then immediately lost it again. Yeah, I believe that is the pot for Khan's glory. And it's Khan's gate. Little statue of a man. Took me ages when I first played this game to figure out that you could go under the bridges. I don't know why, it's the game kind of trained me to avoid everything and then suddenly... Oh, wait, bridges? What? Okay. Here are the palaces of the Khan and his court, each a fortress to itself. Sleek lords and ladies in belted robes breakfast on balconies. An unlikely antelope peeks at you from a park. Guns rotate easily on moated gimbals. Petition for access. We need the leopard's condescension. Offer a gift to the Timon. Cruise past the clan palaces. Khan's glory is a steely beauty, but the clan lords are ever suspicious of spies. Those gun emplacements are vigilant. Well, we've got a 100% chance of success, so yeah, sure. Okay. Lights blaze from every gate and window. You glimpse guards in gleaming uniforms, subterranean gardens of mauve and purple, hanging ornaments of scaled carnelian and jade, statues of warrior Khans past. The water is dark and calm. The sentries watch you with calm distrust. Okay, so we got another memory of distant shores. We've succeeded in the Veil Challenge. Okay, cool. Offer a gift to the leopard. What do you want? Ah. Beans. Okay, coffee beans. Well, let's offer a gift to the Timon. I don't know who these are. The clan name for a sizable ferocious fish of the surface. They have a fondness for drowning pearls for some secret clan ritual. Here you go, I've got some. In the yellow chamber by the palace entrance, a masked functionary scrutinizes the pearls. Yes, she says. Even through the mask, she does not meet your eyes. She rises, turns, and leaves. Let's give him another one, I suppose. Okay, so, yep, we now have more favour with them. Shops, still no shops. Shipyard, nope, still no. Right, well, let's actually talk to Mr. Sex and get our second delivery. The creature calls for you once again. A prize that became a curse. Mr. Sex produces a jeweled bird. The thief thought it would bring her riches. Perhaps it would. But when the gracious widow and the cheery man both covet what you stole, mere money ceases to be of concern. To offend one and make an enemy of the other, she sought a third way, a moment of inspiration that came too late. We want no part in this feud. Settle it. Okay, so we can either take it to the Isle of Cats to favour the widow, or the Cheery Man's agent on Mutton Island. Well, we don't know where the Isle of Cats is, and it's miles away, and the ship's dying, and I believe Mutton Island is there. So... we're gonna go to Mutton Island. Right, well, next episode we're gonna be, well, essentially... stopping off all the ports on the way to get port reports, but otherwise, heading back to London. So, that is going to have to be all for me for now. I've been Humble Better, so I just think it, and as always, keep calm, carry on, good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that, I could have been having a terrible day when I made this video. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. All the same, if you're interested in seeing some live streaming stuff from me, if you look in the description, there'll be a link to my Twitch page, as well as a link to my Twitter in case you want to keep up with all the random gibberish I spew throughout the week, and if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always donate to my Patreon campaign, also linked in the description. Well, that's all from me. This video's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the sideways thinker. Do not seek the pardoner.